It's an overcast but pleasant July 18th, 2002. We are at Northeastern Clinton Central School. This is Calvin Castine, and we're here for action, makeup game action in the Clinton County Firemen's Association Softball League. It's the Champlain team with one Rouse's Point player on the roster, Chuck LePan. And so basically, it's the Champlain team versus the Dannemora Saranac team, but the fellows from the Dannemora Saranac team said nobody from Saranac is here tonight, so basically it's coming down to Champlain versus Dannemora here on Hometown Cable. About an hour or so ago, I was coming from that direction, coming back from the afternoon game, Mets, New York Mets at Montreal at the Expos 1 in dramatic fashion with Vladimir Guerrero hitting a home run in the bottom of the eighth to give the Expos a 2-1 advantage after the Expos had tied it, after the Mets had tied it in the top of the eighth inning. So we come back from that ball game, my son Caleb and I was driving by the ball field here. This is a Thursday. This league plays on a Tuesday normally. So on a Thursday here, we noticed somebody, I think it was Walter LePan, pulling bases out of the back of his trunk. I said, hey, maybe they had a practice or maybe a makeup game. So I came back, and sure enough, we got us a ball game. Trying to squeeze this one in. Let's see, 48 hours ago, I was in Shazy covering a fireman's game. Bruce Barber is going to lead off, the third baseman for Dannemora. That was Tuesday night, then Wednesday morning, out to Messina, the tape history of Messina, with Gordy Little. Then Gordy's on vacation out there, so we managed to sneak in a story while he was out in Messina. And let's see, then following that, we came back and went to Montreal to the ball game. This morning, we took off, went to Waylandsburg for the opening of the Sid Calci Hall of Fame down there, the first pitch Hall of Fame in Waylandsburg. Came back from Waylandsburg, went to Montreal. Now we're here for an evening ball game. And tomorrow morning, we'll be heading for Malone again to meet up with Gordy Little, who is still on vacation. And we're going to tape the little bit of history of the Malone area. Malone and Messina both celebrating 200 years of existence this year. So we're trying to pick up a little history on both communities. And of course, over the weekend, that's a Friday, and over the weekend we'll be at the annual Knights of Columbus Pilgrimage Dinner, which this year will be held in Plattsburgh, Saturday night. Then Sunday, we hope to be in Isle of Mont as a base hit for Barber for the annual Knights of Columbus Pilgrimage, New York State Pilgrimage to Isle of Mont. And when that's finished, we'll be heading for Moores for a Grasshopper Championship baseball game. This is Tim Pellerin, the center fielder. So never a dull moment. So, you know, you come from Olympic Stadium, the press box in Olympic Stadium. And we left early, otherwise I probably wouldn't have picked up this ball game. We didn't. We opted not to go into the clubhouse and get the closing remarks from Frank Robinson. But so we come from Olympic Stadium to a fireman's game, and what better way to end a day's worth of taping than taping the Clinton County firemen. Jim Kowalowski steps in. Nice unassisted put out there at first base. There's the pitch. Outside. Mike Rock on the pitching rubber for Champlain. Foul off. Jeff Reisdorf on deck. Line shot. Ooh. Nothing going to get by there. That's, who's that? Joel Lemire at first base. So two down. Now Jeff Reisdorf, the left fielder. Pitch from Rock. It's hit sharply. Holy cow, Peter Timmins. Defense is as good as we saw in Montreal today. That's pretty good defense all around there for Champlain. Well hit balls by Cernak. Nothing to show for it. We go to the bottom of the first. No score in the ball game. Jim Kobylowski pitching for Dannemora as Walter LePan steps in for Champlain. Ball 2-0. First base for Dannemora is Steve Pierce. The second baseman is Butch Wing number 2. Shortstop is Mike Recor. At third base, it's Bruce Barber. That's ball. And outfield, let's see, somewhere out there, there's Jeff Roisdorf. Brian Cross has a ball hit to the right side. Throw to first in time to get LePan. Let's see, Cross, we got Jim Roisdorf and Tim Pellerin out there. In no particular order, this is Raymond Houston. One out, nobody on in the bottom of the first. Kobylowski delivers. Houston takes ball one. Pitch outside 2-0.
There you go. There you go. Watch these in a run, buddy.
Should be taken all the way. Strike one. Not much arc on that one. Hit to left field to get the sun to battle out there. We do, not the fielders. That's one down. That's, let's see, left fielder is Jeff Roisdorf. Who would, two outs, Chuck LePan will step in. He's one of the Pleasant Valley champions here, I guess. Let's see what that's all about. Pleasant Valley Fire Department champions 1996. Okay, two outs and nobody on. Ball two. I may have mentioned this before. Chuck's father, Charlie LePan, was a player for the old Sheridan Ironworks team, the Harris team, at from Sheridan Company in Champlain. And I played part of one season with that team. And Claude Gooley was the coach of the team when I was playing with him briefly. 1-2-3, Champlain goes down. We go to the second inning, scoreless. Shortstop Mike Recor, the batter, as we start the second. Mike Rock, set to deliver. Hard hit by second baseman Tammy Trombley. And he'll be on with a leadoff single. Now Steve Pierce, the batter, is the first baseman. Nobody out in top half of the second. Also known as Skip Pierce. Places it into right field. And we're going to have runners at the corners. Yeah, bring up the younger Butch Wing.
All right, guys.
And Pierce has a courtesy runner at first base. Runners at the corners, nobody out. Dannemora threatening here in the second inning. Ball one. Only the second game we've taped in the Firemen's League. We don't have a schedule, and certainly has affected our ability to tape. It seems like every Tuesday we're tied up. So tonight, we saw these guys and what looked like it was going to be a game. We thought we'd come back and check it out. That's going to be an RBI single. And still nobody out. And Brian Cross, the right fielder, the batter. Looks like he got a Clayburgh shirt on or something along those lines. That's a base hit. hitting them where they at. Ain't hitting them where they ain't. And it's going to be 2-0 in favor of Dannemora, with still nobody down.
All right, guys, take it off. Take it off.
Nick, no pain here. Nick Payne. The Dannemora team slogan is no pain, no gain. So Nick Payne is the batter. Outside, 2-0.
All right, straighten it out, Mike. Come on, buddy. Right on the plate. Right on the plate.
Come back. Ooh, hits a bad hop. A bad hop. It was coming real nice. Then it hit something.
All right, Mike, shake it off.
Went straight down. Stopped hopping and started skipping. We'll call that an infield hit. Bad hop infield hit, or bad no hop in this case. Jason Carter now the extra hitter. At the plate, still nobody down. 3-0 in the score. It's a line shot. That's a base hit. So Dannemora hit it hard in the first inning, but it was plays that Champlain was able to make. That's 4 runs in. And Jim Reisdorf, the batter.
Same thing, Pete. I'm ready.
Still nobody out. Looks like it already is a big first, second inning here. Big inning for Dannemora. That's through the left side. The fan can't get a handle on it. And we're going to have runners at second and third. Bruce the Barber here. Bruce Barber, the batter. Bruce the batter, Barber. Hits it to left center. It's going to drop in. And we're going to have 2 more across for Dannemora. And about an hour will be Tim Pellerin. Tim Pellerin. Runner at second. Still nobody down. Tough. 2-0 pitch.
All yours, Barry.
Could be interesting.
Run. Where am I going?
And we're going to have runners at the corners.
All right, heads up.
All right, this is Kowalski, I believe. Jim Kowalski. Losing track here. So many batters. That's popped up. Could be trouble. No, it's taken by Rock. Runners will hold.
That's one.
So Kowalski's out, and Jeff Reisdorf will step in. Hit sharply to Timmins. He'll step on second, go to first. In. Oh, it's dropped. Is it out of play? 2 outs.
Oh, it's cool.
Pete, he's Eddie Clutcher doing 95. I told him that was slow.
Mike Recor, who led off the inning. That's a towering fly. Gadway is back in.
Go!
And it's going to be 2 bases.
Closest bag.
All right, now Skip Pierce. Second and third, 2 outs. Pierce hits it to Lemire Bobble. Going to be a foot race. And Champlain wins. We'll total up the runs and we'll go to the bottom of the second. Mike Rock wants to make sure.
Yeah, we got one going.
That pitcher, Kowalski, can see the plate. A volunteer umpire on the bases. And the second inning, bottom half, will start with Dannemora leading 8-0. Ball one.
especially in your shape.
Okay. Yeah, come on now. Pat.
I'm better.
Break one.
There you go, Jim.
Sorry, Mike, you've seen it.
Oh,
come on.
Ball four.
Well, Pete Timmons. Pavelski's pitch swung on, drilled to left center. Jeff in front of him. No throw. That freshly cut grass can be slippery, right? Now Tammy Trombley, the batter. And as you can probably figure out, this is Firefighters League, not just firemen's. Swing and a miss.
Come on, Tammy, bait that.
Come on, Jim.
One out. Or is there nobody out? Nobody out. How is it? Second and third. No advance. Nicely played there by the shortstop Ricor. Now Derek Gadway will step in. Lives around the corner from me. Last time I saw Derek, he was concerned about a dog that had been struck and was in the middle of the road. There's a ball hit sharply to third base, throw to first. He's going to be on. He'll get an extra base on the overthrow. And Timmons will come in to score. He gets an extra base from being on second, so he gets two bases. So Champlain picks up two. They trail 8-2. All right, Will Reno is the batter. Ball one.
Strike.
Sharply, base hit.
Come on, Derek.
Gadway will stop at third base. Runners at the corners. The fire chief, Chris Trombley, at the plate now. And a pitch. Ball one. Duster. Popped up. Oh! Is it a fair ball or is it a foul ball? Walter Penn.
Right
there. I'm not sure where it was. Walter LePan says, dropped right inside. Well, it's where the ball was when it was hit, not where it lands on the ground, but that doesn't matter. It's a fun league here. Base hit for Joel Lemire. Looks like he's got a sore back. Well, he's going to get a runner probably. No, he said, I'll lumber around. Now Ron Houston at the plate.
One down.
Still just one out, and then the base is loaded in the second.
Ball.
Top of the order on deck. We foul. Hit to second. Ricor fires the first, not in time and out of play.
Chris, you got home.
So Trombley will score on the overthrow. Two runs across. Two outs now. Houston ends up at second base. And top of the order, Walter LePan at the plate.
Field off.
Let's see, this is probably the ninth batter of the inning here for Champlain. Well, they've got about five runs.
Yeah, get him higher. Strike one.
Strike. Two-one pitch. lined into right center. Houston will stop at third. Now Ray Houston steps in with his father at third and Walter LePan at first. Ball one.
Ball four,
Houston walks, it loads the bases. And Chuck LePan will step in.
Ball.
1-1 pitch. Just misses. 2-1 pitch. 3-1. LePan hits it hard. Nice play at third. Throw to second. Whoa. Everybody's safe.
In the slide either.
Now Mike Rock at the plate. Base is still loaded. Let's see, Rock is the man who led off the inning, so he's the 12th batter. That's the third out. Ray Houston didn't run, and neither did Chuck LePan. Two outs, those guys have got to run. We go to the third inning. We'll check that score.
Lefty!
All right, the score is 8-6. As we start the third, and Butch Wing at the plate. I don't remember where I saw the elder Butch Wing recently. That's foul. Wing hits it back to Rock. Over to Lemaire, one down.
That's one, guys, that's one!
Now Brian Cross.
Lefty!
Here the pitch. Ball one. It's through the right side. Nick Payne will step in. Nice play. Oh, Houston caught it. He was looking for the throw. It's out on the batter, the fly ball. No force. The runner at first stayed put. So that's two down, and Jason Carter, extra hitter, pops it up to Houston.
There we go.
Nothing across. 8-6. We're going to the bottom of the bottom of the third here on Hometown Cable. Peter Timmons leading off, hits it to the left side. Fire to first, Ricor to Pierce. We have one down. Now bring up the second baseman, second base person, Tammy Trombley. We're in the bottom half of the third, 8-6. Dannemora, Saranac leading Champlain, Rouses Point.
Mike Calhoun's calling out.
Hit back to the pitcher, Kowalski appears, two down. All right, Derek Gadway steps in, takes the ball one. Kowalski's pitch. Called a strike, but a little deep. And Gadway drills it through the middle. Base hit for Derek Gadway. He's on safely at first base. Now Will Reno steps in. And the pitch. Strike one. Line shot to third base. And it's the third out, I guess. Nice grab there. by the third sacker, Bruce Barber.
That's 3.5.
We go to the top of the fourth. 8-6. Jim Reisdorf, first ball hitting, gets it off the glove of Timmons into left field for a base hit as we start the fourth inning, 8-6 ball game. Top of the order up now, Bruce Barber, the third baseman. Almost halfway through the ball game. Here's a pitch from Rock. Strike. Slow bouncer, Timmons will go to second. Safe at second. Tim Pillar in the batter. Get what you want, Skip, I'll work around you. Fouled, strike one. Fouled a fair ball.
Right over the plate.
Went over the orange part, but run scores. And Barber ends up at third.
You don't call fair ball.
All right, now we got Jim Kowalski. Line shot. Oh, got a force at second. Go to first, not in time. Gets Barber home. It was a good idea there. Trombley tried to slap it in the air to Timmons. Almost worked, but she didn't quite get it to him in the air. She didn't drop that. She was trying to hit it off her glove and knock it to him so he could catch it and turn double play. Jeff Reisdorf hits it deep. Walter LaPan on his horse catches up with that one. They have a little trouble getting the outfield here because the sunlight. As soon as we get sky in the picture, it gets awfully dark. Now, Mike Rico on the batter. That's hard hit. Nobody's going to catch that one. Kowalski going to stop at third. Rico coasts into second base with a double. Okay, now Steve Pierce. Reisdorf's going to run for him. Knocked down by Rock, and everybody's going to be safe. Base hit for Pierce. Now Butch Wing at the plate, strike one. Neither runner left the bag. If they'd left the bag before the ball's hit, it's an out. 1-1 to count. Could be trouble. Houston's calling for it. At third, he grabs it. So two stranded. We'll go to the bottom of the fourth. We'll figure out how many runners cross the plate.
All right, guys, let's get them back.
Chris Trombley at the plate. He's going to face the new pitcher. Who's the new pitcher here? Carter. Jason Carter is pitching. Real pitch. Trombley reaches for it. That's grabbed in right field.
One down.
For the out by, I don't know. Originally it was Jim Reisdorf. That's not Reisdorf. That might be, Pellerin. At any rate, this is Joel Lemire. Strike one. 11-6 the score, bottom half of the fourth inning.
know, me too.
He must be related.
Halter. Hey.
Strike called.
Isn't that bad, Joel?
Behind the batter.
32.
3-2, full count. Foul ball. Ball four misses outside. So Lemire walks. And now Ron Houston will step in. One on, one out in the bottom half of the fourth inning.
Strike one.
Hit two short. Ricard goes to second for the force. Throw the first will not be in time.
Two down. Good try, Joel.
Top of the order now, Walter LePan, the batter.
Big one.
1-1.
Level swing, Walter, level swing.
Oh. Right, two.
Two balls, two strikes.
Ball three.
Full count. And a payoff pitch. Inside, Walter LePan takes the walk. He'll chase Ron Houston to second. And Ray Houston will step to the plate. Team down by five in the fourth.
Strike
two. And Jizz misses. 2-2 pitch. Pops up, out of play.
Can I lend you a hand?
Full count. On the payoff pitch with two outs. Walk would load the bases. Houston's going to swing. Hits a slow roller to Ricor. Fires to first to Pierce for the out. Nothing across for Champlain. We go to the fifth inning. 11-6, Dannemora leads.
All right, Pete, what are we doing?
This is Brian Cross. He was the right fielder after all. Nice catch by Gadway. Derek Gadway making a nice grab there in right field on a high, hard hit ball. Nice grab. Pete Timmons has moved to pitching spot. Ronnie Houston has moved over to shortstop from the EH position. And it's bringing up Joe Moore up for the first time in the game. Joe Moore, no relation to No Moore. It's a line shot, gets by Houston into left field. LePan will pick it up. Moore might settle for just one. Now Jason Carter, who's the new pitcher, steps in. He was the extra hitter. Pitch from Timmons. The top of the fifth, 11-6 the score. Hits the back corner of the mat for strike one. Here's the pitch. Popped up, that's gonna be strike two. Souvenir for a young fan. Uh-oh. 0-2 the count. There's the pitch. Popped up, it's gonna roll foul. Pitch from Timmons. That's out of play. Two foul balls in a row on a third strike. You're out and it's called a strikeout. And when you strike out, you gotta buy a case of beverage. League rule. Now Jim Reisdorf at the plate. Here's the pitch from Timmons. Reisdorf lines a shot to left field, right. Rock, excuse me, not right, but Rock. Mike Rock. Reich is a combination of Mike Rock. Mike Rock, makes the catch on the line drive. We go to the bottom of the fifth, 11-6. Dannemora leading Champlain here on Hometown Cable.
Way to keep them.
Chuck LePan at the plate. We're in the bottom of the fifth. Here's the first pitch. It's ball one. Clinton County Firemen's Association softball, ball two. We are proud to cover this league. There's a strike. It's the least we can do is cover the Firemen's Association when they're out here enjoying themselves, not battling a fire somewhere or some other emergency. And as we have learned with floods and ice storms, and of course a rescue squad with many years of automobile accidents and heart attacks and sports injuries and so on, but as we learned also with the floods and ice storms, it takes more than fire to just fire, things other than fire I should say, get these guys out. They'll come out for any emergency. So firefighters is really a misnomer. They are emergency personnel. This is Mike Rock at the plate with Chuck LePan on with a single. There's a pitch from Carter. Strike. Strike two. Rock looking for a free pass. There's the payoff. Popped up to shallow left center. It's going to drop in. LePan will stop at second. Now Pete Timmons at the plate. 11-6 the score here in the bottom half of the fifth. Makeup game in the Fire Association. Timmons hits a slow roller to the left side. Throw to second, throw to third. We'll have runners at the corners. They get the middle runner. Good one out. Tammy Trombley steps to the plate. Strike one. One pitch. Ball three. Trombley swings, hits a soft liner. Oh, the header played. Reisdorf fires the first double play. Pierce kicking the bag all over the place. Reisdorf, Jeff Reisdorf have had her played perfectly. And Timmons looking like it was going to be a base hit all the way, was off and running, and he's doubled up. So a good smart play there for Dannemora. Takes a rally away from Champlain, and it remains 11-6 as we go to the sixth. Bruce Barber, first ball hitting. Holy cow, look at that. Send for rescue hose number five. Mike Rock coming in, making a heck of a catch. Still got enough energy to go back to his left center field spot. So Barber is out and Tim Pellerin at the plate. Strike one. Line shot. Holy cow, look at that. Looks like the first inning all over again. Great play by Lemaire at first base. Two outs. Champlain defense shining again here. Now Jim Kobolowski started the game as the pitcher. Swings and says, I'm going to get this one by Lemire. And he does, just barely though. And Gadway hustles the ball in to Trombley. And I have a two-out single for Kobolowski to bring up Jeff Reisdorf, who made that real good play, getting the line drive, taking the base hit away from Tammy Trombley and turning it into a double play. Here's Timmons' pitch. Weisdorf hits it to straightaway center, Walter LePan. Camps under it. He's as good an outfielder as you're going to find in this league. Walter LePan hauls it in. And we go to the bottom of the sixth, still holding at 11-6, Dannemora. Derek Gadway at the plate. He's going to lead off in the bottom half of the sixth inning. In the pitch. Strike called. Is it to Recor? Fires to first. Pierce, one down. All right, now we get to, let's see, Will Reno. Strike one. Base hit, right down the line. Reno's going to try to stretch it. He is safe on the sliding second base. Brings up Chris Trombley. And the pitch. Went to second. Recor is there. Two down, and Joel Lemire steps in. And the pitch. 11-6 is going to the bottom of the sixth. Lemire off the glove. Nice play, a nice try by Barber. And Reno scores. It's 11-7.
I guess.
And Ron Hewson, the batter. I'm here holding his back still. Houston, the batter. Top of the order on deck. Pitch to Houston. Ball one. 11-7 in the sixth.
I want Andrew over there. It's too close to the wall.
Hit to Recor. Came up a little soon on it. Said, where'd the ball go? Where'd the ball go? There it is. Reisdorf found it. Now Walter LePan.
I said no.
And the pitch. Ball one. Ball. Runners first and second. Fouled out of play. And a pitch.
Let it go.
Barber grabs it. We go to the seventh, 11-7. Dannemora leading Champlain on hometown cable. Mike Recor, the batter. As we start the seventh inning, four-run ball game. Recor swings. It's a high towering fly. This could be trouble. Gadway coming in, not going to be able to get there in time. Now Skip Pierce.
Don't stop.
The line's shot. It's going to be extra bases. Reisdorf running for him.
Get it in.
Rock will pick it up. Here comes Recor. Here comes Reisdorf. Here comes the throw. The line in. Reisdorf scores a home run for Skip Pierce. Didn't even have to break a sweat. That's his first home run. He owes it all to Reisdorf doing the sweating part. Now Bruce, no, this is not Bruce Barber. Let's get back to where we are here. Even though Reiserv just scored, we're not at there. We are at Butch Wing. It's a line shot back to Timmons. Isaiah caught that one. So that's one down. Now Brian Cross. Foul, not a play, strike one. Timmons set, and a pitch. Hit sharply, nice pickup by Lemire, and just in time for the out. And he reminds him that his back hurts now. Two down, nice play there by the first sacker. And Joe Moore, the batter. Pitch from Timmons. Back to Trombley. Trombley over to Lemire for the out. And we go to. You see that,
Dan? That's how you do it.
We go to the bottom of the seventh. 12-7. Dannemora leads. Raymond Houston, the batter. The bottom half of the seventh inning in a seven inning ball game. Strike one.
Ball two.
Two and one. July 18th, 2002, Thursday night makeup game. Ball hit through the left side, base hit. Eisdorf fires it a bullet in. And now Chuck LePan will step to the plate. I've got a 12-7 score. Ball three, and a pitch. Strike. Full count, and the pitch is taken. Ball four, so LePan draws a walk. Chases Houston the second. Nobody out. And Mike Rock, the batter. And a pitch. Three and oh pitch. Tim Rock taken. Ball four. That's going to reload the bases. With nobody out. Pete Timmons will step to the plate. Ball on to Timmons. Base hit. So score a run. LePan will stop its third. RBI single for Timmons. And I've got 12-8 now, but we're hearing the Champlain team say 13-8 instead of 12, so whatever. Now Tammy Trombley hits a comebacker. They come to the plate. Look out. Oh, look out.
That's like running into.
Moore hung on to the ball. Now Derek Gadway. Base hit. Yes. Gadway with a base hit. About a 12-9 score according to my score sheet. Now Will Reno, the batter. And the pitch. Just a shade outside.
Ball two.
2-0 the count.
Well.
He's taken all the way on the 3-0 pitch. Strike. Inside, Reno draws the walk. Reno walks. Timmons scores. We're looking at a 12 or 13-10 score. Tying run is on board, either at second or third, or excuse me, at first or second. Chris Trombley at the plate with one out. We got a new pitcher here. This this I think is Pellerin. Says he's ready after one warm up. Pitch to Trombley. And oh, strike one. Up the middle, base hit. Here comes Gadway, he's gonna score. Trombley comes through with two runs batted in. Joel Lemaire, the batter. Ball one.
Watch him, Joel. He's here to walk and run.
It's either 12-12 or 13-12.
Easy, buddy.
One out, Ron Houston on deck in the bottom of the seventh. Strike. Barbara will step on third for the force. Two down. Safe at second.
Flash down.
Ron Houston, the batter. Here's the pitch. One pitch. Fair ball. Looks like a line drive in a scorebook. Ron Houston is on.
The
bases are full for Walter LePan. So I believe the scorebook has it 13-12. As I said, we've got it 12-12. But we're not going to say a word because we have no involvement in this game. We're just here to tape it. Strike one. But LePan gets a base hit.
Ball one.
We got Houston on deck, right? Houston on deck. 1-1 to count. Two outs. LePan hoping for a walk. Strike two. One ball, two strikes. And the pitch.
There it is.
Hit sharply through the infield. Trombley scores. Here comes Lemire. He scores. Neither one of them touched the plate, but that's the ball game. 14-13. Champlain with a big come from behind. Joel Lemaire scores, and I think that's it. 14-13, I think. No, they're saying it's tied now.
No. It was. They had 12-13 before.
Hey, all you got to do is drop it on the ground, buddy.
What do we got? Ray Houston's the batter. We gotta figure out the scores here. Yep, they've checked the book. And it is 14-13. So
that is the game!
Champlain with a big seventh. Seven in the seventh. Come from behind victory. The Champlain. A little help from Rouse's Point defeats the Dannemora Saranac team, and that's the way it was. July 18th, 2002, you've been watching Hometown Cable's coverage of the Clinton County Firemen's Association softball. Thanks for watching, and particularly for those of you who are supporting Hometown Cable's ongoing efforts.